First game, Pong to serve, love all.
So here we go, Pong to start with the serves. Best of five, love all.
One,
and a good old
love.
Traditional pendulum serve to start for an outright point. Pong getting off to a good start here.
One, oh.
Good placement here from Sutton, despite being a bit out of position and driven back behind the table. Now he's got some serves of his own to set it up.
2-1.
Nice third ball attack from Satyan. Goes cross court with the forehand and then the backhand cross court as well. So he's
one,
a very
three.
Quick player. He doesn't give his opponent much time at all to even you know, take a breather in between points.
Right.
1-4.
And I imagine there will be some settling in from Ko and Pong. But the truth is, Satyan makes it so uncomfortable and just changes the ball every single shot. Like that one right there barely came off the back of the table, but not mandatory.
5-1.
Good combination here. Good opening forehand and then the follow-up off the bounce.
Yeah, I thought Satyan did well to block that top spin from Pong, but... look at that return.
2-6. Sometimes if you're a little bit tense, it's very tough to adapt, change your timing. I wonder if there are some nerves in Pong's game right now. From a step or two behind the table. Short play to start, but as soon as the ball came long, got comfortable with that forehand attack.
8-3.
But even from the previous point, we saw Satyan staying so close to the table. Even when Pong is playing the forehand topspins, he's not backing off.
4-8. Nine.
The backhand topspin attempt by Pong goes just long, so it's a good lead in this opening game for the player from India.
9-5.
It's funny, we can talk a lot, I'm sure, about how much India has improved ever since the start of UTT Ultimate Table Tennis, having six men in the top 100. Right at that transition point. But I do believe that we're going to see more and more coming up in Singapore, like we have in this tournament. A lot of homegrown skills out here. So 11-5.
Satyan is number 33. Sharath Kamal is 34. And we have a woman player, Manika Batra. She's world number 46.
The women are doing quite well from India in this tournament. We can talk about them more in a bit. Monica, as you mentioned, has done quite well with WTT so far this year. 20. Quite a rally here, though.
One,
the speed keeping that racket high for all the counters. The leading man of India at this moment, Satyan Yanashekaran, taking that point.
Great rally by both players. This is easily the best rally in the match so far.
1-2. And it's been outdone and then some right after calling it, and you were dead on with that. But this point, we saw defense, lobbing, counterattacks, footwork, feeling. Satyan very patiently waiting, keeping it to the backhand court, testing the opponent to try and counter from far away with the backhand, which is not easy to do.
Yeah, and as soon as Pong fell away a little bit away from the table, he found himself in trouble.
And typically that happens to a lot of players. Wang Chuqin hadn't been beaten by many foreigners, but Satyan was one of the last foreigners I recall beating Wang Chuqin. And a big part of that is his timing. It's not easy to stay close against Satyan. Back edge of the table here, but kept deep well, acknowledging the fortune. Pong. He's got a lead by one now.
beautiful angle from Satya. And the first ball was played cross court.
So right out of the towel break, tied up. Cohen Pong with the serves. Good placement here. Satyan jamming him into the elbow, shutting down that third ball attack.
Again, he's taking use of that angle. That ball was away from Pong's backhand.
4-0.
Very difficult to receive. An excellent receive here as well. I've seen a lot of people have trouble with Satyan's tomahawk serve. Satyan was very successful using that against Tomokazu Harimoto in their first ever encounter.
Pong getting into a good rhythm now. He's coming out with the forehand topspins, and he's putting pressure on Satyan's returns on the blocks.
Scoreline quite different than in game one. What, 11-5 in the first?
Yes.
And he's fired up. When he's vocalizing like this out here, you know that he just really has the passion to continue, and every point matters so much, especially here in front of the home crowd. Ooh, perfect placement from Satyan. And then the fast footwork, Pong still gets a racket on it.
5-5.
A nice change in depth on the push. I think Satyan thought it was going to be coming a little bit deeper. Had to play it from out in front, trying to lift. So 3 points between them and 3 points away from the finish line, Singapore's Pong.
8-6.
Pong not happy with that return at all. He should have made a return to that. Satyan had to play a shot. But I think he just tried to play too deep.
Do you mean to say that he should have hit the ball on the table?
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay.
He feels that.
9-6.
Understandably so, but quickly regathering his composure, sets himself up with a 3-point lead here. Satyan with a bit of self-conversation, as he will have between games as well. Very surprising and clever placement there from Satyan to go deep into that backhand once again. Two big serves here for Satyan.
Top edge
of the racket. A bit of kick and a timeout here. I think this is a good time for a timeout for the young player. Haven't seen it happen professionally, but who knows.
Play.
Quality long push right out the gates on the receive, and a quick fourth ball attack to follow up. And on the parallel, he does it. Backhand down the line. The timeout has been spent wisely. One game apiece to get back in action for game three. The momentum continues, Varsha.
Yes. I mean, he's done really well to win that second game, has Pong. After dropping the first 5-11, he overcame his nerves. He started attacking the balls more, and it's paid off for him. And he's won the first 2 points in the third game.
What do you think Satyan has to do to make Pong more uncomfortable and get back that lead?
I think he started the opening game by attacking more. And he just made a few mistakes, though they were, they were brought on because of Pong's very good play. But he has to keep level with Pong now and attack as much as he can, as soon as he can.
And again, for people who are newer to top-level professional table tennis, it might be a bit of a surprise that they're hitting the ball at each other instead of trying to hit it out of reach, but they're playing for positioning, trying to catch the other one off balance. So like in the point before this, for example, you could see a lot of attack for that elbow of the arm with the hand that holds the racket. Pendulum serve here, drifts just long. Keen eye, short stroke from Satyan to get in with the opening attack, but well prepared. There was an answer on the other side with Pong.
3-0. 4-3.
He's just served long enough for Pong to play that slow backhand open. He needs to keep the ball much shorter than that, I feel. Especially the service.
Come on, come on.
four.
Fired up. You should have seen the look Varsha gave me. Good times, good times. Tied up 4 points apiece.
Play.
And a kick serve
five,
here.
Four.
Now that apology there, deep on the table, I think Pong felt that he was in a position where he was in trouble. Satyen had set up the table well to earn this point, and there was the net is actually what it was, a bit of a clip off the net.
Yeah, but the last point, I thought he just rushed into it and he felt he should have done better. Two very important serves coming up for Satyen.
Five, six.
Two shots there from Satyen, clipped the net. The first one where Pang was able to return, but Satyen closing in 5-6. This match is proving to be much more, much closer than we expected, but it's really good shots by both players. And
six,
Satyen
four.
There, the ball clips the net and flies out from Pang.
Play.
Seven,
play.
Six.
So back in front, Pang. If he takes this game, there is some serious pressure on the relatively veteran player out there right now.
Oh!
7-0.
The ball very close to the sideline from Satyen. So all Pang could do was just play a defensive return.
I think we're going to have ourselves a screamer of a game three here. A game that could be decided and must be decided by at least 2 points.
Seven,
an excellent
nine.
Short return played by Satyen. Pang first initially thought he could play the topspin and at the very last second chose to play the chop, and that chop goes into the net. So a good 2 point lead, 9-7 for Satyen.
Five.
8-9.
Pang gets the third ball attack that he wanted because of his serve.
Big serve here, chance to level it out. Again, this is the game. If he goes down 1-2, I think we're going to see Satyen with confidence. We're going to see him loose. It's going to be very tough to come back from. And heavy spin on
nine,
two shots
four.
In a row. Dead even, 9 points apiece, serves with Satyen. Big
ten,
point here.
Nine.
Uses the serve wisely, gets in on the attack quickly, and earns himself game point.
Yeah, he played a good chop return there, did Satyen, and Pang was just forced to play the chop return back, and that allowed him to play the forehand topspin.
Goal!
These yeah. 2 points, nine. Two in a row, serves used
game
very wisely.
Love one.
Sometimes just a very faint net, something that we don't see so clearly from a little bit farther away. The players will acknowledge their fortune.
One, oh.
I've got to say, no matter who wins this match, I'm very impressed with Pong. Mentally, he seems strong. He's got the right ideas, sort of orchestrating the points well.
Yeah, and he's only 19 years old.
One,
I mean,
two.
Even though he's ranked 140 in the world, he's lucky that he got a wild card here and he's able to showcase his talent. And he definitely has so much of talent. Being a left-hander, he's played some very, very good shots.
This time just a little bit earlier to get out to that wide forehand. Shot taken from slightly more central on the table than the last time we saw this pattern. Bottle challenge serve goes just a bit long. It's a gutsy serve. Table, the short side there, not as much margin for error. Well, now that two serve sequence wasn't quite the two serve sequence we saw from 9-9 in the third for Suthian. Good spin here, Suthian with the kicking shot, jumps up to find the edge of the racket. That serve was outstanding. He got Suthian to pop it up a bit, but inside the table in the forehand flick, not an easy shot. Let's take a look at this pendulum serve here. Look like heavy underspin, but when it looks like it, can be deceptive. It can be so frustrating to have someone you can't hit it through with that many quality shots. It's like when you get started playing and your coach just blocks forever.
Yeah.
And eventually you just try to hit it as hard as you can and you miss.
Excellent blocks from Suthian in that previous shot, in the previous rally.
5-0.
I think he's getting a little caught up with the balls played to his body. He's just not able to maneuver wide enough to play a full-blooded backhand topspin. He's just caught in the center of the court.
That was a smart flick. It wasn't going for broke. It was just enough to put some pressure on. He says, okay, you want me to take the first swing? I will. Did a short play here. Both players protecting the attack. Very smooth from Suthian. From that second camera angle, we could see how quick it was and how low it was.
7-5.
And when you step around, you leave yourself quite exposed on the wide forehand.
8-5.
Excellent blocks again from Suthian. Very, very good top spins played by Pang, but look at the way he's just absorbing the pace. This one right here, and then, you know, Pang, the third, fourth shot, he has to play one extra shot almost in every rally.
Right, and they're big shots to recover from time and time again. Constantly looking for the perfect place. Clever touch shot. Suthian sees his opponent backing up, taking that step back for the big opening forehand and decides to play it short. Just a simple touch push shot.
Six, nine.
Still a ways to go, but closing the gap up to just 3 points here. Pang with one more serve to get within two. Suthian 2 points away from moving on to the next round. They have warned the players not to touch the table here. Sometimes you might ask, why are they doing that? Typically to remove the sweat from their hands. Good power on this one. Suthian with a little bit of a lob there, but. A little bit off the net in that last one, but a very strong opening receive from Pang. And a timeout now on Suthian's side. Okay. And going for the big counter, an outstanding point. And he does it. Suthian Yanashekaran fights through hard. Any questions about if it means anything to him right now?